I'm Gina. Today I show you what to make my manicot. Okay, this is the manicot and I already feed. Okay, I'm ready for make a salsa. I have to make a salsa before I start. I have to make the manicot. But I gotta make a salsa first. And that's it. I have the tomato sauce in the jar, al basil, little onions, little garlic, this go in the gravy. So now I start. And then when they fry, this is a gravy, no meat. When they fry, I take this out. Let me put it here. And then, now I'm gonna put oil, olive oil, so olive oil. I put the olive oil, but two spoons of oil. Let it fry, warm it up. When it warm it up a little bit, you put onion. Okay? This a little here. Now, this we have to do this. Let it fry a little bit, but you can put it together. They fry, you gotta wait. You gotta wait till they fry, okay? So, and then when they fry, because this is a different gravy, no meat. I need to put for the manicot. It's plain, like they say, plain. But my sauce, it's plain. You have to make a little oil, you know, fry something, they make a little sabor, taste of the gravy. They fry. Because in this sauce, they just plain, just tomato sauce, and we pass it to the machine, it's a nice clean. They gotta fry. Onions, they're done. No little bone. Just to make a little color like this. No little bone. Just to make a little thing. Now I take it off. Okay. I put it here. A little I think 2 jars is enough. Wow. My God, it's so strong. That's why the jar keep 2 years and they don't go bad. They lack good. Now I make I don't have a fresh basil, okay? No, you want fresh basil, but I have in the jar, the same thing I have in the jar, the fresh one I have in the jar, you see? When we make a sauce, we make the basil. But and I make not a little more than this, the dry one. See, the dry one, just a little bit. That's enough. See? And that's the gravy. That's it's no meat. The gravy no meat because we use it for the manicot. Now I put the salt. You pour and then later you taste. Okay? This is one. So this is it. When you end the jar, just wash a little bit. You put a little water. So you put a little water, you put in the jar, and now you wash the jar like this, and you put in the gravy. And this is the gravy. Now, the time of the cook the gravy, we gotta make the dough for the manicotto. We gotta make the crispelli. This will be like this. Like this, make the fiammelle low. They go nice and easy. And this is already, the sauce is already. Now I prepare for the crispella. You know, for the crispella, they call manicotto, you know, the rotella for make the manicotto. When I make, you follow me, when I make, you see what I'm gonna do. So that's 3 cups of the milk. And you can put 1 tablespoon of the butter in the milk. And then you gotta warm it up. Supposed to be a little warm, the milk. No hot, just a little warm. And you put on the stove. At the time of the, just put, I gotta put a little salt, just a bit of the salt. Just a little bit of salt. I put in the milk. Just a little bit of salt, and then they can warm it up. When they want this, you can put in the egg. You can put up here already. This is not ready, but the eggs you can put up there. Everything will go in here. We put four eggs over there. Let me see here. Okay, this is done. Now I need this one. This one, this. You put in the way, because you put everything in here. And this is for the crispelli. Now you start the machine. I put the salt, I put the burro, and I put the eggs, and now we start with the use of the machine. And that's the flour. You gotta put a little bit of time.
Let me see.
know, like a cream. Supposed to be like this. Because when you're making the casserole of the, they make a run, you know, they got a run. Okay, now we gotta cook. Now you gotta see the cook of this. Yeah, now I put over there. We gotta go in the, on the stove. All right, now we start another thing. First I want to show the, I want to see the gravy. It's a cook. Supposed to be 8 hours, it's okay. Because of no meat, it's okay. All right, now we shut it off for this. Okay, let me shut it off for this. And now we come on the dough, the rodelle, we make the rodelle. The first in the beginning, you have the grease a little bit, and then the continue, you don't need anymore. So here we put this, and not too much, just I gotta make a... Okay, little, you know, little grease in the beginning. And then maybe you don't need, you don't have to make more. You can just put a little bit like this, here grease. It's a borrow, little borrow. And now you start, I make a little low here, not too much high. And we see what happened. You see, that's a cream. You see, that's a cream. Now we start like this. I put this. When you put this in here, just you have to do like this. You gotta do like this. And that's the crispella. Rodella, look. They gotta cook a little more. They come on one side, you just turn like this. Now the first one, it's a little wide. But when we continue, they can come a little brown. Supposed to be little brown. This is it. That's a manicot. Okay. Now they start a little brown. Like I said, the first one it's a little wet. Okay. Now you don't have the burr anymore. No burr. But just to put this. Right away you have to do like this. Right away you have to do like this. You see? Yeah. Gotta wait, gotta cook a little. I think it's high up, you know. See? They start the brown now. I stand the brown. Okay. And this one, you put the ricotta, you turn like this, and that's the manicot. We gotta make later, one thing at a time. One thing at a time. Just to put it here, right away, you do like this. They got to run. See? You don't want it too thick. You got to put more or less, like less thing. Less, look. That's the color supposed to be. You see? Now I got to put a little low, otherwise. This is
Did you make these in Italy?
No, you know, they call it different way. I know they make them. They call it cannoli. I don't know, cannoli. This I learned here. When I come here, my husband and they show me this thing. I make all the time. Especially in the holiday, because of this it's a little work. And number one, number two, you know, this one you can make a day before. You can make a day before, put a couple of days before, and you put in the refrigerator. And when you are ready, you know, they can stay a couple of days because they take a long of a make. It's better. Just when you put this, you gotta do it right away this, otherwise they cook and I have no time to wrap. This is more. Sometimes I make a little less. It's more. That's for the baby. The small one for the baby. I don't have a baby. The marijuana of the baby. Yeah, like when I come here, I learn a lot of new stuff I know. And I cook because I have four children. Every night I have to cook. And when they like something, they want, Mommy, you gotta make this. Mommy, you gotta make this. And so I was working. I was do everything. Make up the kids. They go to school.
Where did you work?
I was working in a machine shop. Machine shop, even down at Grove Street. I worked for 18 years on the machine. They make a piece of the airplane, a piece of the car, small piece, sometimes big, some small for the little clock. You know, the little screw for the clock? For the watch. Was hard work. It was okay. When you're young, you do everything. Yeah? When we come here, we have no house, so we live with my aunt. The name Concetta, la zia Concettina, God bless. Now she's not here anymore. She died. And when I come here, she saw four children. He said, this is the Italian. She started to make cookies. And for my children, it was a surprise. You know, we never have an Italian like this. So they say cookies this way, cookies that way, they were so happy, they eat. So I have to help her, and that's why I learn. I have to help her to make them. But she showed me to make. She said, this, they come from Italy, the children, they're strong, they're healthy, and they eat everything. You got a cookie. I cook. Everybody grow up happy. They start the school, they go to school. And I'm the older, the children too come next to me. They big, everybody they big. some come nice, some even because my hands go. My hands are after this. I'm happy when I cook. I like to sing. I like to do something, but I pay attention here. I do nothing. Okay, just I want to say God bless America. That's what I want to say. That's all. Oh, here we are, everything. Why you have to work? You're lazy, you don't have nothing. You work and you have something. That's the last one, okay? That's the last one. Just to put, you think you are, you slap the cup sometimes, you think it's too hot, and you do like this. Yeah. That's it, that's the last time, okay? Now you see what I make. Now we gotta make the filling for the manicotti. Now we make the filling. I have 2 pints of the ricotta, I have 1 pint of the mozzarella. This is 1 pint. This is for the filling, and this when I finish the manicotti, I put on the top. After the finish, I use the put on the top. And I got 4 eggs. Every pint that we got, 2 eggs. This is a 2 pints, I put 4 eggs. So, and now we start. You can put a little salt, a little black pepper. That's a tasting, for tasting. All right, this is a ricotta. You can use any time the ricotta, whatever you like. Somebody, they like one cambane, somebody like another cambane. Whatever you like, you can make it. You make the manicotti. Okay, it is done. Now we pour. Oh, the granny cheese. I forgot the granny cheese over there. We need the granny cheese. See? Now, we make this mozzarella go all here. This mozzarella go all here. You can make I test it, you know, the cheese, you can make half a cup of the granny cheese. You can make half a cup of the granny cheese.
Is that Pecorino Romano?
Pecorino Romano, si, Pecorino Romano. Now you make the eggs. You put the eggs. Okay, that's the eggs. Then you put the parsley, all the parsley. And mix. That's the filling. You can put a little salt, you gotta taste. You put a little bit and then you taste. Everyone a little black pepper. Somebody want more, somebody want a little bit. Somebody don't want nothing. It's a lot of, this is a testing. The way you want to test it. See? And this is the feel. This is the feeling. I make a little more of this. Yeah, that's it, that's enough. For me, it's like this. Somebody want to make a different, they make more, or don't make less, they make an uptake wherever they want. Now we can taste what's the salt. Okay, and now we gotta fill the, this is the stuffing, okay? Let me test this good with the salt. I need a little spoon. Probably more. All right, that's it. So this I need a little, this and no more, this I can put more, okay, that's it. The pecorino romano, it's salt too, anyway, that's why you gotta taste. All right, now we put all that together, we have everything, we do the thing, we do the gravy, we do everything is already. Now the last operation. Let me say like this, the last operation. Let me test the gravy. Let me see the gravy is okay. It's so good. It's good. You don't need nothing. We don't need nothing. Now we use this one. First of all, you put a little gravy in the bottom, like this. See? For the gravy, you put a little Parmesan cheese, like this. Now we start the manicotti. We have a 30 manicotti, 30. You see? What do we do? You can pour like this. See? And then you do like this. You do like this, and you pour over here. You pour like this. You stir this inside. One spoon. Everyone, one spoon, a little more, depending on. And then you do like this, this is it, and you pour it like this. See? You pour like this. When you put all the thing the same thing, when they cook you just pick it up and this go like this. You when they cook you pick, you gotta start this side. They all are the same side, same time. Okay, now this tray is full. Now I finish the fix. First of all, I put a little Parmesan cheese. Okay, put Parmesan cheese. Then I put the gravy. Like this. And that's the mommy got. Now you put a little mozzarella. Put a little mozzarella on the top. That's it. And this is it, right? A little more parmesan. This is done. I gotta make another bread, okay? First, second thing, first I gotta make a gravy in the bottom, like a gravy. And a little cheese. And I start. I remember one day, my friend, this is a long time ago, because this we don't make all the time. We make a special day. They come some other day. You invite somebody, you can make it every day because it's a lot of work, you know. But when you gotta make, you can prepare before. Like I said, to Rhode Island, you can make 1 day, 2 days before. That's a big thing for the cook, that one. And so I made. One day I went to the, I was at work at that time, anyway, I was at work. But she asked a favor, said, gee, my daughter get married, and next week he bring the parents home. I want to make something. I know you make the manicot. You help me to make a manicot? I said, why not? Sure, I help you. She was not far away from me. You can work for go her house. And after the work at night, it was a night, I go in this house, I go make a home. I say, I come at your house and we make it together. And you see what I am, the way you gotta make. And then we make a lot. And then, all the time she said, thank you, Gina. That night was so good. Everybody was like the man of God. But you have to see, sometimes you can tell, they tell what the way you gotta make, but you have to see. You gotta see. I was lucky, me. Last, I was to stop the work on the machine, and later on I found a job in the bakery. I worked 7 years in the bakery. Was so nice. I was enjoying myself at that time. But it was so nice because I know speak good English. And over there you have to speak. The people come and buy the cake, they buy the come and buy the cookies. I have the fortune myself of speak. And then I learned to speak English. Not really, but it's better than I think. The bakery was, the name was Stop Shop. I was working at the Stop Shop. And I don't know nothing for the store, you know, I was working the factory. I learned, I was doing better, good job I do. And some people, they say, now you learn to make a cookies, and now you learn it's not true. I can learn because the cookies, they come frozen already. They make in the big company. I don't know what they make in the big company. And when they come, they're in the box, frozen in the box. You just pick up the cookies and put in the tray and they cook. I can learn nothing. I want to learn, but... They already make. And so it was a nice time. I was to work over there, it was a nice. And I cook home. That's a Gina, and I cook home. I cook for my family. Now we put, make two big tray, see? Bye-bye, this is the last one. Okay, we finish. This will be the last one here. You see? Now I fix this one. The last one, and I'm so happy it's done. See? I put a little grain of cheese. Now I put the salt. The salt's nice and fresh, we just make. Yeah. You make a loaf. That's a little basilic over there. So now I put the mozzarella. We put the mozzarella. You want more mozzarella, you can put more, but it's enough because it's inside, outside, a little bit too much. Let me pour more sauce. Go like this. You can use the spoon sometimes, then no gorra. You can use the spoon like this. You see? You can put the spoon like this. You can put the spoon. I'm so happy, I finish. I make all this. See? All right. Now, this is done, this is done, this is done. But this is not finished yet. Let me see. I want to clean and run. I want to clean. You know? Because you're not clean, they're born. And they're not good. You see? You clean it here. You clean it here. Now you put aluminum paper, you cover, and you put in the oven at 315. 315 about 45 minutes, 1 hour. Sometimes you check, sometimes the oven is crazy too, you know, they don't work all right, I don't know. You check it. It's better when sometimes you check. Because when they cook, they rest a little bit, they go a little up, they go a little up. Voilà. At night we celebrate. We have nothing to celebrate, but we celebrate the special food. We celebrate the special food. Okay. And you put it here. A 3:15, make 1 hour, 45 minutes, 1 hour. Okay? When they cook, I show you what to eat. All right. I want to see my manicotti they already. Let me see. Here. Ah. Yeah, they already. Look at this. Look at this. That's one. This is two. We make a 2 trays. See? Then they cook. Let me see. cook now. Now let it rest for about 10 minutes. 10, 15 minutes, let it rest a little bit, okay? I cover up, I cover back, a little rest. Okay? And then already filled. Just a little bit, then I taste. Now it's better for pick it up. Now it's better for pick it up. You take some, you do like this. You put in the dish. You want another one, you could pick like this. So you can move like this, and you take one at a time like this. See? Okay, this is the two, you see they come out together too. One, two, three, enough for the dish. Now what I'm doing, I put a little cheese. I put a little cheese like this. And I put a little gravy. Okay? That's a nice feed. This is a really feed. Now it's the time for taste. I want to taste. I talk. I never really want to taste the man I got when they come. See? Look how nice. The cheese, everything is nice. That's so good. Look inside. You see inside, look. When you cut like this, and you can take a bite, you see? See how nice. That's good. Okay. Hope you enjoy to see this. And you like, and you make, and I'll see you next time. Okay?